a devolved subject, and health-related issues were devolved in 2011. So the provincial governments are have their own cells, but we are we work with them in coordination. So it is mandated to take legislative, administrative, and coordination measures to reduce prevalence of tobacco use and fulfill the national and international obligations. Next, please. So what can we say the major achievements in this due course of time? The legislative policy measures one, to notify the pictorial health warning. So it is now 50% size on both sides of cigarette packs and outers from June 2018. It was challenged in Sindh High Court, but no restraining orders. So 60% from 1st June 2019, new enhanced size pictorial health warning will be notified. So case of 85%, pictorial health warning is in the courts. I think this year we, due to COVID-19, we could not work on this, but now we are back to the normal activity, so we will be working on this. So ban on sale of cigarette in loose form, ban on manufacturing, importing, and selling of cigarette packs having less than 20 cigarettes. So ban on import of shisha and related substances. Reconstitution of committee in tobacco, advertisement guidelines, tobacco industry participation ousted, representation by provincial governments and professional associations, ban on printing of promotional messages on cigarette packs. So ban on tobacco advertisement promotions in print, electronic media, point of sale, ban display of tobacco product and point of sale. And on electronic media, you can see that if in a drama or in a serial, even they show that smoking is injurious to health. So declaration of places of public work or use completely smoke-free, illegalization of designated smoking areas. A few years back, the designated smoking areas were approved, but again, at airports and other public places, but now there are no designated smoking areas. Cessation of protocol on illicit trade in tobacco products and ban on taps on point of sale and retail incentives. Next, please. So awareness, capacity building, awareness is very important for this important risk factor to inform the public and especially the youth about its dangerous outcomes. So two national mass media campaigns were launched in collaboration with other partners, Sponge in 2016 and Tobacco is Hollowing You Out 2015. So for time to time, we are in coordination with PEMRA to air tobacco control messages. These are the public service messages, and they are gone free on air. Campaign in cinema theaters across Pakistan, capacity building sessions. They are across the country. They have been by the provincial government and also from the federal government. This is an example of like campaign board installed at Urology OPD section CMH Rawalpindi. So monitoring tobacco use. For tobacco, the time to time, the various surveys have been done by WHO and Communicable Disease Control, Global Adult Tobacco Survey 2014 and GYTS in 2013, and again in it is in process of 2019. It is not yet completed. And Pakistan Demographic Health Survey has also indicated in 2018 survey. Next, please. So enforcements, who are involved in the enforcement? Of course, like for taxation, FBR is important, but then excise and taxation departments, the law enforcement and agencies, police, magistrates. So we are in coordination with provincial chief ministers, federal secretaries, provincial chief secretaries, chief commissioners, and ICT, various circulars by police and raids by law enforcement team. Now, up till now, I have informed what is the role of the government and what they are doing. But the role of NGOs are very important. They are crucial to successful tobacco control efforts. Effective tobacco control efforts require comprehensive, multi-pronged approaches and strategies. They have more political independence than government or NGO. They can raise their voice. Somehow the government itself cannot do that. NGOs can better catalyze and coordinate NGO coalitions, can provide powerful briefings for government to use, provide expert testimony on the relevant issues and research. Next, please. They can support country in implementing the FCTC, include training for policy makers and health workers within government, the drafting of model legislation to illustrate the breadth of legal change needed in a system for it to comply with the FCTC. Expert workshops in implementation issues associated with specific article of the convention. Work with government to increase capacity to educate, evaluate, conduct surveillance and report tobacco statistics. So the biggest role played by NGOs in tobacco control in Pakistan is the acceptance of tobacco consumption as a human rights issue. Change of norms of society, now smoking in public places is taken as not normal activity. Launched nationwide many campaigns including for raising tobacco taxes and withdrawal of third tier of tax in recent past. So NGOs have successfully raised awareness that tobacco consumption is not only a health issue, it has serious repercussions on poverty and economic stability. Next. I think it's the last slide. So thank you very much.